Okay, students, welcome back. We are, this is demo 902. Today we're gonna talk about low waist or dropped waist skirts. This will be in your textbook chapter 13 on page 234. We're gonna talk about how we would drop the waist and create the waistband facing. So I'm gonna be using the white side of my point paper. Remember the marking sides you want to be on the inside. And we're gonna be working with our basic skirt blocks. We have our front skirt and our back skirt. Remember when you're drafting, we always wanna make sure that we are looking at these where we have the side seams as if they would be kissing one another. So the side seams are facing one another. The first thing that we need to do, same as we've always done with our front, is we need to draft our grain line. So I'm gonna draft here my center back grain first. I'm using my L ruler. And if you're using the point paper, you can align with the point paper to help you mark up, line up. So you can see how this would line up here on your center back grain line. And then we want to mark where we want our hip line to be. Our hip line is going to be perpendicular to that. So that's why I like using the L shape ruler here. The hip line will be perpendicular to the center back grain. So that this panel will line up here. And then since we're drafting, we can do the same thing with our back, noting that this is gonna extend into infinity. Imagining that our center front will, you wanna line up the front and the back along the same hip level. And we wanna make sure that we're drafting a nice, clean line for our center front. Now it's really important that when you're drafting your grain lines, don't just use your sloper. You wanna use your ruler to make sure the grain line is straight. The danger is if you don't, over time, your slopers are gonna wear out and the line is going to become less accurate. So in order to maintain the accuracy, that's what the purpose of the rulers are for. So then you can see how this front lines up. There you have it with your center front grain and your hip line. Okay, now we're ready to begin. So dropped waist means that we're going to be reducing the waist of our our front and our back. And a drop waist or a low waist is really a design line. For the purposes of this style line, we're gonna drop our front 3 inches from below the waistband. So we'll be dropping the front and the back 3 inches below. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna first line up my pattern piece here, and then I'm gonna finish tracing it off. So we have our waistband, our first dart leg, continuation of the waistband, second dart leg. We are going to trace off our side seam. It's always nice to use weights. Make sure that your sloper doesn't shift in the middle of what you're doing to ensure that it stays stable and accurate. Make sure that you can use your awl or your compass or your push pin to mark the apex of your darts. And for this, so note that these were your original dart legs. This is the one closest to my side seam. This is the one closest to my center front. And to ensure that we are all on the same page, I will mark the center front on this. I'll make this hip line a little bit darker so we can clearly see what we're dealing with. This is my hip line. This is my center front. This is my center front. Yeah. Same thing with the back. I'm going to trace off my back. I'm aligning the center back to the grain line that I've drafted. I'm aligning my hip line. I'm going to secure my pattern piece with my weights. And then I'm going to trace off the top of the waistband, my dart legs. My side seam. Note my hemline. I am using my awl to mark my dart, the apex of my dart legs. You can use your push pin. Note, then I can now draft my dart legs. The dart leg closest to the center back. The dart leg closest to the side seam. And I want to mark that this is my center back and this is my hip line. So these are things I need to make sure I'm remembering. So right now, all we've done is trace off the front and the back. Now we can begin designing. So on the front, we're going to be dropping our waistband 3 inches. So I'm going to take my graph ruler and I'm using it and I'm marking 3 inches down from the top of the waistband. This will be my new waistband style line. Same thing here from the side seam. I'm going to measure to use my graph ruler on that side seam, and I'm marking 3 inches down from the top of the original waistband. Now I need to create a new waistband there. I'm going to be blending from this 3 inch mark to this 3 inch mark. This is still on the front. This is a good place to use your French curve or your hip curve. Again, you want a gradual curve, so you're working basically between the 11 and the 20. And you want, remember, this has got to be perpendicular here. So notice as I'm drafting this line, in this particular example, 3 inches fortunately happens to fall below the darts. So basically what you've done on your front, you have now eliminated those darts based on the ease that you're using. But we still want to create some kind of shaping in here. So on your side seam, we are going to shave off 1/4 inch. So we're shaving off 1/4 inch from the side seam. And then we're going to blend that back into the side seam. So just like we did with our princesses, we know that we need some stability here through the hip area. So I'm going to cut note 2 inches below that new waistband, and that will be where I'm going to blend my shaved off mark to. So 2 inches below that new waistband. I'm using my French curve. We've gone in 1/4 inch to create some added fit, and I'm blending in using my French curve. On a nice, gentle curve there. So this will be my new side seam point. Then the back. So on the front, we dropped our waistband 3 inches. I'm going to need to mirror that effect onto the back. So I'm going to take my graph ruler and mark 3 inches down from below the top of the waistband. Same thing here on my side seam. I'm going to mark 3 inches down below the top of the waistband. So this is just like the front, 3 inches down, and just like the side seam, 3 inches down. So were we to walk these pieces together, they will match. Notice, however, that when I now I'm going to blend from my new side seam point to my new waistband point, there still will be darts. I'm going to use my French curve to gently blend between these two. So you're between the 10 and the 20, basically. You want a nice, gentle angle. The side seam will be higher than the center back. Notice that you still have these darts. There are darts on your back in order to get fit. Now, just like we did on our previous example, we could convert these two darts into a single dart. We could do that by finding the dart center and taking the dart pickup and putting them all into a single dart. Or we could leave those two darts here and we could convert to a single dart. Same at the front, we shaved off a quarter for fit. Remember, this is sitting lower on the hip, so you want it to hug the hip. And then we need to do the same thing here on the back. So I'm going to mark 1/4 inch from my side seam. Remember, this is for fit. And then for stability, I'm going to kind of note 2 inches down. And that will be where I blend my new side seam mark into. This now becomes my new side seam mark. So I have 2 darts here. I have no darts in my front. And for a skirt like this, instead of a waistband, we would want to create a waistband facing. In addition to that, well, the center front might be on the fold so that we don't have a seam. The back, we need a zipper. The side seam is shaped curved here, so you wouldn't want to put a zipper here at the side seam. You'd want it at the back. So I'm going to create an extension of 1 inch for my zipper. Notice that when we go to create these panel pieces, you're going to need to notch where your original center back was. So we're going to talk about how we transfer this new waistband into a waistband facing. So using my point paper, I'm going to line this up and we're going to trace off the work that we did earlier. So I want to draft a grain line, noting where my original center back grain is. I can, with the point paper, you can see where your design lines were from previous. So you're going to transfer that waistband. And remember, the side seam waistband that you're doing is the point that we now have made 1/4 inch shorter. And we have our extension, our 1 inch extension. We have, and we also need to take into account these darts. Now, a facing is going to be 2.5 inches. That's your standard waistband facing here. So I'm going to draft down along my center back. And this is that extension, the zipper. So we're going to draft down, marking on that center back 2.5 inches. That will be the depth of our waistband facing. The same thing with our side seam. We're going to draft down on the side seam 2.5 inches. And you will use your French curve to gently blend those together. Now, we're going to use the slash and spread method to close these darts. So, finding the center of the dart, you're gonna slice. You're going to cut. And using our scissor, we're going to cut on the first dart leg. And we're going to need to close that dart. So you're creating a more shaped waistband by doing this. I'm going to put this on the brown paper so you can see more clearly. And let me grab my tape. So we had our darts, this is our transferred waistband from our back. We're slash on the darts. We're going to pivot that dart leg closed. So you're creating a more curved outer circle on that waistband extension. Same thing here with this piece. I want to pivot so that this dart then closes. I tape it. With a nice piece of tape. So now when you go to finalize the waistband facing draft, you're gonna need to re-blend this exterior seam. So back to my French curve or my clear curve ruler, you can clearly see here, if I take my red pen, now I'm gonna have to blend that exterior seam back together. Same thing here. You don't want a jagged waistband facing. You're gonna use your pen to blend that piece back together. But then the last piece is to finish drafting your seam allowance on your waistband facing using your graph ruler. The top of the waistband facing is, seam allowance is only 1/4 inch. The side seam would still be 1/2 inch. And where those dart legs are on the skirt body now will be noted as a notch on your waistband facing so you know where to align this. Your center front will be a notch on your center back, rather. You have the 1-inch extension, and then you'll have 1/4 inch along the bottom for your seam allowance of your waistband facing. On the front, we had no darts, so you don't need to worry about closing any darts on the front waistband facing. You're going to note this as your center back. You would note this as your back waist facing. You'll need to cut two. You need to note this is a size 8. And of course, your year and season and who you are. You'll notch your side seam, seam allowance. Make sure you clean it up when you're all said and done. But that's how you do a drop waist. This was demo 802 on the drop waist skirt with a waistband facing.